Continuing with our tutorial, one of the things that I'd like to do is show you a list of control key commands that may be useful from the command prompt. I've put together a little document that we should take a look at. So within the Open VMS DCL command line editor, there's some control keys you may want to take advantage of. Control A toggles insert on and off. On some systems, insert is on by default. On most systems, insert is off by default. So if you are typing a command or recall a command and you'd like to up arrow and move into the command and change the text, Control A will let you toggle that on and off. Oftentimes when I'm working with text either inside the editor or at the command line, I want to jump to the end of the line, so Control E takes me there. That's a shortcut for that. Control H is a shortcut to jump back to the beginning of the line. Again, this works either at the command line or inside the editor. Control O toggles screen output on and off. I may want to turn screen output on and off when I've given a big command to the system and it's busy doing work. Programs run faster if they don't have to update the screen. Note that screen output automatically turns back on in case of an error. So if you've turned output off and you walk away from your desk and come back and find your screen flooded with messages, you've had some sort of error. Control Q. Well, let me talk about Control S first. Deck terminals had a hold screen button, and this invoked the Control S command that computers seem to have had ever since we got the first screen and keyboard. Control S pauses the screen or holds the screen output, and then Control Q releases that. Control T is nice. Control T gives you the status of the command interpreter, so it can be used to show you that CPU is ticking and I/O is running and what user or process is running. In some cases, even it tells you the name of the program that's executing, and in some cases it tells you what that program is processing. So for example, during a backup, Control T will show you what file is currently being copied. Control W. Some applications look to the Control W for refreshing the screen, but not all applications, so this may not be real helpful. The delete key, depending on your keyboard settings, may delete the current character that the cursor is sitting on, or it may delete the character to the left of where your cursor is sitting. So again, this depends on your keyboard settings. It occurs to me there's a couple of additional commands we should take a look at. Control Z, Control C, and Control Y. These are interrupt characters in increasing severity. Control Z closes the current input, and in some programs that also causes them to stop. Control C is the cancel command. This is a little more severe than Control Z, and again, this is what some programs are looking for to exit, such as some of the Pi utilities that update the screen continuously. This is also a gentler way to kill a program. And then Control Y is the interrupt command. In Unix, they might call this the kill with extreme prejudice. So if there's a program running and you want to stop it interactively, Control Y should stop that for you. Continuing with our discussion of VMS commands, I'd like to remind you the control keys we talked about for interrupting a program. There are a number of Pi applications that shouldn't be interrupted. So for example, on your Pi 2 server or on your Pi net node, if the Pi start or Pi net start or the Pi stop or Pi net stop command files are executing, you wouldn't want to interrupt those with Control C or Control Y. Continuing on, there's a show default command. It'll always show you your current directory. In this particular case, I'm using an application that changes my prompt to show me my directory, but you may be typing on a system that doesn't have a custom application like that, so you may be just looking at a dollar sign or some other kind of prompt. So show default can be used to show you where you're currently pointed, if in doubt. You can also use command set default to change your directory. So let's say I want to go to the VMS administrator's working directory. That's a directory called sys$ manager with a colon on the end, and that'll take me to that directory. Now I can use the show default command to confirm that I'm there. Another show command that may be interesting, show device D, will show you all the disk drives on your system. In my case, I've got two disk drives, a DKA300 and a DKA400. 300 looks like it's online and mounted. That happens to be my operating system disk and where we're going to put Pynet. DKA400 shows online a write lock, and if we looked into this device and its features in more detail, we'd learn that it's the CD-ROM that's connected to our system. There are two types of executable file in VMS. One is a command file. You can think of that as being a text file with a script of commands to be executed, along with comments or data. The other is a binary, executable, and these have the extension .exe. So let's talk about how we can execute each of these. In my directory, I have a number of command files. These normally have the extension COM, but they don't have to. I've got a command file that checks to see what kind of machine I'm typing on, and I can execute that with the @ sign. Okay, the .com is assumed, so I don't have to type that if I don't want to, and that then causes it to execute. So what this command file does is it tests the machine to find out its name, current date and time, what version of VMS I'm running on, and then the processor type. In this case, we're typing on a machine that happens to have a VAX processor. In another directory of my machine, there are a number of exe files. Helps if I get the command right. And these are binaries, compiled programs, and I can execute those with a command run. And since I'm not in the directory where those live, I need to type in the fully qualified file path. And for example, CLS is a program that clears my screen. There's another program over there called Cookie that puts up a funny little message. Okay, so what we learn is that we have two ways to execute things on VMS. Command files get executed with an @ sign, and executables, exe files, they get executed with a run command. Okay.